Pseudo-nitzschia species are potentially toxic diatoms. Some are capable of producing large quantities of domoic acid, a neurotoxin that bioaccumulates in shellfish and forage fish, such as sardine and anchovy. Consuming these toxic shellfish can lead to sickness in marine mammals and seabirds, and to the syndrome known as amnesic shellfish poisoning in humans. In this video, we'll help you identify three types of Pseudo-nitzschia species. Many species look similar under the light microscope, so we'll mostly be using size and shape to help classify these species into groups. Pseudo-nitzschia australis, a large type Pseudo-nitzschia species, is toxic and similar under the light microscope to Pseudo-nitzschia fraudulenta and Pseudo-nitzschia hyemi, both generally non-toxic species. They are normally found in chains, have more rounded ends than the other types, and cells and chains overlap about 1/4 to 1/3 the cell length. This cell type is 6.5 to 8 micrometers wide, 75 to 144 micrometers long, and cells have one side that is generally straight while the other is bowed or bent. Pseudo-nitzschia multiseries, also a large type Pseudo-nitzschia species, is toxic and indistinguishable under the light microscope to Pseudo-nitzschia pungens, which is generally non-toxic. The group is also normally found in chains, and the cell ends appear more pointed than the previous group. Cells and chains overlap about 1/4 to 1/3 cell length, and, like all the other Pseudo-nitzschia species, their two chloroplasts are golden-brown in color and are located on either side of the central nucleus. This cell type is 3.4 to 6 micrometers wide, 68 to 140 micrometers long, and both sides of the cell are the same, both appearing generally straight. Pseudo-nitzschia pseudodelicatissima, a small type Pseudo-nitzschia species, is toxic and similar under the light microscope to Pseudo-nitzschia cuspidata, which is also generally toxic, and Pseudo-nitzschia delicatissima, which is generally non-toxic. This group can be found as single cells or in chains, and the cell ends generally appear pointed with a cell overlap in chains that covers about 1/8 to 1/9 of cell length. This cell type is 1.5 to 3.4 micrometers wide, 50 to 140 micrometers long, and both sides of the cell are the same, both appearing generally straight. Here's a quick review of characteristics from the video to help you identify these Pseudo-nitzschia species.